Hi guys, welcome back. I hope you all are doing great. So a few weeks back I did a pack haul video. In that I featured my pack beauty blender, and a lot of you requested me to do a video on this, like a review video on this. So I thought, why not do a comparison video instead, because I know a lot of people would like to know how does the pack blender score against the original beauty blender. So I'll do a quick demo for you guys and I'll go over some of the key points. Now the pack beauty blender comes in a box like this, and this retails for 485 rupees, and the original beauty blender comes in a pack like this. It's available on Nykaa and I think also on Amazon, and it retails for 1899 rupees, which is pretty expensive. And honestly, there isn't much of a difference when it comes to the application bit. They both pretty much give you the same results. The only difference is that the original beauty blender is way more porous and softer than the pack beauty blender. This is still very soft as compared to other beauty sponges and beauty blenders out there. I think the pack beauty blender is the closest to the original one in terms of results. Although sometimes if you layer your foundation on with the pack beauty blender, depending on the formula, it can lift off a little bit of foundation. It's only if you apply 2 to 3 layers on top of each other and if your blender is dirty. That only happens when you have a lot of product deposit in the blender. And when it comes to cleaning them, it's pretty easy to clean both of them. Only the pack beauty blender takes longer to dry. What I like to do is I use baby soap, and once I've cleaned it up completely, I take a tissue paper and I wring the water out, and then I just leave it near a window to dry wherever there is direct sunlight coming in. When it comes to blending, the pack one takes a little longer than the original beauty blender, but I think it's totally worth it for the price difference. It's the closest you can get to a beauty blender if you don't want to invest 1900 rupees, which I feel is a little too expensive for a sponge, but I get it. It's a great tool. Also, make sure you clean your beauty blender right after using it. I did the mistake of not doing that, and then I ended up with like black spots and it was really gross. I had to throw away my last blender because of that. Make sure you clean them right after you use them, and you can use baby soap. I did buy the original solid soap that comes with the beauty blender, but guys, it's just baby soap, so you can use any baby soap and it should work perfectly fine. So if you're in the market for a new beauty blender, then I highly recommend the pack one. Also, be very careful while washing the blender. You don't want your nails to like touch the sponge when it's wet, because it breaks easily. So yep, that was my review, guys. Also, I'll have all the links in the description box below. If you have any other suggestions, leave them in the comment section below and give this video a thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't already. The subscribe button is right there, and you can check out some of my other videos over there. And there, I think I'll have the pack haul over there, and I'll have something else over there. Okay, so make sure you click on them and follow me on my social media. I'll have them linked right above. I'm Sonal Sagaraya everywhere, and that's it. Bye.